She's on a high. Actually, she's always high. And I don't mean the drunk high. She is happy high, and touch wood for that. And if she ever falls, she knows she can pick herself up and move on. And that's the real strength of a woman. I say, no guts, no glory. Friends, this new age woman is none other than Anushka Sharma. Anushka, welcome to Starry Nights.
Thank you, and thank you for your kind words.
You deserve each word of it, I think. Do you think you've been lucky to be at the right time, at the right place?
You know, I think one doesn't know why things happen in their life. So I think it's always better to just give the credit to luck. Because you don't know. I mean, like I always say, you know, anybody else can be in my position. I'm never making claims to being the most talented or the most good looking or the most anything, you know. But the fact that I'm here, there has to be a reason for it.
So most lucky.
And I really believe in karma and all of that. So I think my pichle jam ke karma na bade acche the.
You believe in karma and believe in fate, destiny, etc., etc.
Yeah, but I also do believe, like, I change it to, like, my convenience. I also believe that you can change your destiny.
You actually think
if it's not going your way, you just change it.
But have you ever thought if you were not in films, where would you have been?
Well, I thought I was just going to be a model. Mm-hmm. But now when I'm looking back, I feel like how much modeling would I have done for so many years? I was anyways, like, quite bored of it because, you know, when you're modeling, they just want you to walk with no expression. They'll say things like, no expression. I was like, what is no expression? Right? I'm feeling these clothes. I want to like express something. Yeah. And like no expression. So I was like feeling very restricted. Mm-hmm. So I'm sure I would not have lasted very long.
And do you think you have that edge over other actresses that you select the right scripts, the right stars, the right directors, the right makers, and therefore every film of yours somehow clicks and clicks in a big way?
I don't think so because I feel like everyone's doing some really good work. It's often, in my case, I cannot make a comparison with anybody else because, you know, I actually find it very taxing to do that. So even this thought for me to process it, I'll have to really think about somebody else and what they're doing. And it's not something that I can really, I can manage. So what I know is about myself. And I know that, yes, it's, and we've spoken about, you know, that in the beginning of my career, mm-hmm. a lot of people would give me gyan and tell me, you know, you must do more films and out of sight is out of mind and like, you know, market yourself better. And I was like,
and now you think they must have been out of their mind.
I mean, at that time also I thought they were out of their mind. But I was like, what is this nonsense that they're talking? I mean, mm-hmm. What's the point of just doing films if you're not doing anything in those films and if you're not leaving a mark, then there's no point in doing films. So I kind of stuck to my beliefs.
But you've always been like that, following your instincts, headstrong, not the one to conform to set precedents and set
standards.
I've
always been very anti-establishment.
Really?
Yeah.
Anti-establishment, anti-advice.
Yeah. Advice, it depends on who it's coming from also. The thing about me is that, and you can ask all my directors, I cannot do anything unless I'm convinced about it. So you can't convince me to do anything. Mm-hmm. You can convince me. I mean, you cannot make me do something. You have to convince me.
Huh.
And I'm a very reasonable person like that, so I understand and I try to get the other person's point of view. So I guess that's why it's not something that I can't conform that easily because of this reason. Of course, I've taken a lot of advice that people have given me, which
correct.
Has been good. But this particular thing, I think you do not.
See, you said you're reasonable. And I know I'm very, very good at convincing people. So I'm going to convince you to dance and sing on the show.
I refuse.
Are you a singer? Can you sing to save your life?
Okay, have you heard my voice today?
What does it take to convince you to get up and put on your dancing shoes?
I'm actually not a person who likes dancing. I don't enjoy dancing or anything. So I just do it because it's my job. So I like doing it when I have to actually do it for a song. Otherwise, I hate it. I hate it when people tell me, get up and dance and start dancing. You know, I hate it because I feel like it's like that time, you know, when we were kids and our parents used to say things like, hey, meri beti bada achha karti hai, mera beta
bada achha karta
hai. Ye dikhao and all. So I find it like that. And I'm like, now I'm like an adult, you know, I don't want to be treated like that. So I'm like, I don't want to dance.
But any childhood memories where your parents used to say, meri beti ye achha karti hai, and you would have to do it?
I really enjoyed it.
And what would you do? What were you good at?
I really wanted to. When people used to come to my house, my parents, friends and all of that. I thought I should hang out with them. I didn't think I connected with their kids. I thought like, this is my, these are my groupies. I want to hang out with
them.
And
what would you do to impress them? Or what would your parents make you do to impress them?
See, the thing is, I think somewhere you only hear praise from your parents in front of people.
Yes.
Otherwise, they don't praise you. To your face, they never praise you. They never say, oh, she's good in studies and all that. So they would always praise me in front of their friends. So I used to love listening
when the friends came home.
Yeah. Because they would say things like, she's come first in class. You know, she's doing really well. Last year, this and that. And she's in the dance team and she just took part in this debate and like, so I'm like.
You were good at studies, huh?
Huh.
You were good at studies.
Yeah.
And debates also.
Yeah, I used to do everything. Like I would.
So you were the all-rounder student? Mm. Wow. Yeah.
Like anything that was happening in school, I wanted to participate.
You know, there's this belief that only those people become actors who are not good at other things.
That's not
so
true,
you disproved
actually.
That theory.
You know, the bizarre thing is when Aditya Chopra was signing me for this film, in fact, he told me I was doing the film, but I know that he'd had a conversation with Manish where he'd asked, is she an achiever? Like, has she been? So Manish said, yeah, she's, you know, she's... So I think that's something that Adi also understands. I think the thing is that it's not like I was interested in academics or or sports or dancing or anything like that. But somewhere that I always wanted to be best at everything I was doing.
Well, that's a very good quality, na?
So I guess that's what I think Adi is also like that because nobody knows, but Adi is a very good dancer and he's won all competitions. In that competition, the competitors...
Oh, really? Nobody knows this.
And he's won over Hrithik Roshan. So Adi is a very phenomenal dancer. And apparently Adi was defeating everybody. Like he was a very good dancer. No, Karan Johar has told me this.
Oh, yeah. And Karan Johar, of course, would know.
We have to trust his knowledge.
Karan Johar also said when Adi was introducing you, he told Adi that his choice is the wrongest choice.
Yeah, don't take
and
her.
This girl doesn't have it in her.
Yeah, don't take her.
And when Karan Johar signed you for his film, did you give it back to him? You thought I had no future in this industry?
No, this is the sense of accomplishment where you feel like if... One thing is that to meet people like you, you know, as an actor, obviously you want that, you know, you want people to like you. That's what encourages us. But when you know someone didn't like you, you know, and then you can transform them in such a huge way where they take you for their own film. I think there's no bigger accomplishment than that.
Yeah.
You know, so I was just like, I was just very happy. Like.
And who told you this, Karan himself, that he had prompted
Little
Adi?
Little bit I'd heard also.
Acha.
Before.
So you had secretly hated
Karan? No, not at all. I don't know whether it was him.
Okay.
But I knew like some friends of Adi's didn't want me in the film. So I used to always look at all his friends thinking, yeah. But I don't know who it was.
But in your wildest of dreams, you couldn't have thought it was Karan Johar.
Not at all, because he was so nice to me the first day he came on set. He was just so nice to me. Then I went back and told my mother, I said, Karan Johar is so nice, ma. I was sitting alone and he came and spoke to me and all that. Cut to Karan Johar telling me this story about how his mom told him, she's sitting alone, go and talk. He's like, oh God, I have to go and talk to her also. And I was like, Karan, you're such a good actor. You can fool people. So I thought he was so sweet. But it was nice of him to say it on national television. I think that the acceptance of it was, kind of cool of him.
Yeah, exactly. There are genuine friends in this industry.
When we say friends, you know, I think firstly, as a person, you know, me personally, I don't have too many friends, okay?
You're not a people's person.
No.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not. I'm not someone who needs to hang out every evening.
Okay.
In fact, I don't want to hang out every evening. So I have friends who are not actors, who are not celebrities.
But do you get time for them?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it's very chill now with them. Mm-hmm. I mean, we meet sometimes. Even they don't expect anything out of me. They don't expect me to call them. And I'm not good on the phone. So I'll reply to messages after 2 days and all. It's like really bad.
Whom do you connect with at home?
My brother.
The maximum?
Yeah.
Who is also your partner in production?
We're not twins, but we could... Very well have been.
Really? Yes. You're so close to him. Yes. You'd confide everything in
him. Everything.
And he likewise?
Likewise, yeah.
And you all got close right from childhood? You all were close?
No, he used to really ignore me. Like, he was very bad to me. He's 4 years older than me.
Older,
And he used to just ignore me in school. So I was this kid.
You all went to the same school?
Co-ed school.
Went to
the same school.
Okay.
And I used to see him coming and I was like so excited that I'm going to say hi to my brother. And he was a celebrity, okay? Because he used to play cricket and his name was on Hall of Fame in school and all.
Okay,
so I was like, he was a celebrity. I was like, my brother, I want to see him and I want my friends to see me saying hi to him and all.
So they should know that, you know, I'm so-and-so's sister, huh?
Yeah. So I was walking and all and I'd be like, hi, bye. And he's like, just look away and start walking and talking to his friends.
But then when did y'all get close and how come so close?
I think he got close after he went to Merchant Navy. So he was very young himself and he joined the Merchant Navy and used to correspond over letters. So I think that's when we kind of, I guess somewhere it's easier to write to people than to talk to them. You know, so I think we would share a lot more things when we started writing to each other. And also that distance that
distance makes the heart grow fonder.
And that distance is not like he was gone for like a few days. Like he used to be gone for six months, you know. When he used to come back and I had obviously grown up, I had become older. So I was actually, I would say, cool enough for my brother to talk to. You know, I've become cool.
And now do you give him the cold shoulder because you're a bigger celebrity?
I'm his fan.
You're his fan even now?
Yeah.
And is he your fan?
I don't think so.
I can't believe that. Who isn't your fan? So would it be right to say that you would have not turned a producer and that too at such a young age had it not been for Karnesh?
1000%. 1000%. Yeah.
So the idea, the germ of the idea came in your mind, his mind?
The germ came in my mind.
Uh-huh.
But it was something that both of us used to discuss about.
Okay.
ये क्या है, हम कैसी फिल्में बनानी चाहिए या whatever that is.
And the script, who's got the better script sense, he or you?
I think we both take decisions on that together.
Okay.
Because it's like, you know, we actually don't have any particular roles that we play.
Seamlessly,
all. Seamlessly, okay. We just like sometimes I will say something which normally is a part of filmmaking that he usually talks about, but I'll suddenly have a, you know, opinion
okay.
on it.
Okay.
And sometimes it's the other way around. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes that's just how it is. But I think with films, with scripts and all of that, my brother's always had a very good, he's had very good script sense.
Okay.
You know, he was the only one who's ever read any of my films. Like, I've never given it to anybody else.
And you always give it to him or sometimes, occasionally?
Always gave it to him. Really? If he was there.
Uh-huh.
He was not there.
Exactly.
Obviously not. Exactly. But when he was there, mm-hmm. yeah, I used to always ask him. So that's how we, even today, that's how we take decisions. You know, it's like always, we discuss with one another and we are very thick. We have those very similar mindsets, you know. And yeah, like our friends say, we just are like that. We're like that relationship. Perfect understanding. Yeah.
So when you got into a relationship, was he the first confidant?
Into a relationship as in?
Into being friends with somebody. So would you confide in him?
My brother?
Hmm?
Yeah, I guess.
Or the brother hai, toh thodi sharm aati hai. He's older than me. Not that kind.
It's a koi illegal kaam thoda.
Ah, exactly, exactly.
I believe in very basic things in life.
Uh-huh.
I believe in, like I'm kind of, everything should happen at the right time in life. And,
okay.
You know,
okay.
I'm not someone who, I mean, of course, I'm very ambitious and I'm very career driven. I guess it's like the right balance of being, like how today's Indian women are, I think. Mm. I think there's a great balance of being traditional at the same time, moving with times.
So would the industry lose you to marriage
not
pretty
at all.
Soon?
Please, not losing me.
Because you said there's a right time.
I'm 100 years old.
So you feel 100 is the right age for marriage?
I think 100 is... Why about marriage? These are two very unrelated things.
No, in the sense, I agree. These days, even married girls are working, doing very well. See,
yeah.
Sri Devi, English, Winglish. But does it mean that marriage will happen exactly at the time it should happen, around 29, 30, or not necessarily so?
You're indirectly trying to ask me when I'm getting married.
No, not really.
Huh? Of course you are. See, I think, like I told you, I believe in karma and I believe in things happening when they're supposed to happen, you know. So I feel like things will happen when they're meant to, and there's nothing one can do about it. You know, I think these things are always...
For someone who started the interview saying that I can change your destiny.
Yeah, I can when it's not going my way.
You're fond of living out of the suitcase.
Yeah, but then it gets to me after a while. So when I was shooting for Ring, we were away for almost 3 months. After the third month, I was just like, I don't want to be in a foreign country. I want to be in India. Yeah.
And India means home or... Achha, you're a home bird basically?
Totally.
So if you're not... Which must have been some 5 years back that you're not shooting for 1 month together.
No, but if you there'll be a period, no, even if like 4 days or so. I'm not like, I don't want to meet anyone. I just want to be home.
And those 4 days, you want everybody to be around you or you want to be by yourself at home?
See, the thing is, with family, that's the good thing. I mean, you can be with them and you have the option to not be with them also. But I live with my family, you know, so I feel like this is important for me because as a person, I'm very simple and I feel like I have kind of, prioritize my life in a way that I know that these things are important. So I think anything else doesn't fall into my scheme of things. So for me, spending time at home, being with myself, I think these are very, very important things, you know, because I always say this, like for me, I treat my career, my work here, I treat it as a job, you know, so I don't get emotionally attached to people from here, you know.
Really?
Yeah, I have no attachment with people.
Quite an art, that's quite a quality.
But it's not like I was born with this quality or I came into this industry with this quality. I was taught to become like this, you know, because I started to see the way in which, you know, people shift and they change and people just treat you on the basis of your success. Everyone, not just, you know, you can't say, oh, the industry, everybody, like the media, like everyone.
Have been more successful than not successful.
But there was a period after my first film, you know, after Rabne released and I wasn't like an overnight star with that film, you know, as...
What Although that film was a huge hit. Yes.
Exactly. But like, people appreciated my work and all of that. It said good things.
Maybe because there was Shah Rukh Khan in it, so.
Yeah, maybe because of Shah Rukh Khan in it. But I didn't like turn into an overnight star.
Overnight star. Very true.
The one to
very
watch
true.
Out for. And I wasn't getting all the debutante awards and all of that. So I feel like it was kind of like a lull for me, you know. And it took some time for me to sign my second film. And in that period, I actually saw the way things were, which I didn't know. Obviously, I thought this was normal. But it's after Band Baja Barat that I saw people suddenly change. You know, like suddenly people were like wanting to talk to me, wanting to invite me to their parties and all of that. And I was getting swayed in the beginning. You know, I was like, wow, how cool am I? Look at me. And then I realized that, okay, why is this happening? Like, why is this suddenly happening?
So it was self-analysis or somebody brought you to...
No, self-analysis. Okay. So I realized that, okay, this is the way this place is. And it's very good to have that equation with everybody, you know. Mm-hmm. Because I feel like I'm a more professional person because of that, because of this mindset. Mm-hmm. Because I don't emotionally attach myself with mm-hmm. people. Mm-hmm. I believe in doing my job mm-hmm. and that's it. And I don't expect anyone to do anything more than that for me also. The way I'm as a person, I believe that when you detach yourself from people and mm-hmm. somebody, I think mm-hmm. you are of more service to them than Correct. You would be if you're attached, because attachment exactly. is actually very selfish.
Exactly.
Attachment
exactly.
is a very selfish yeah, thing. You want yeah. something, that's why you're attached to
Kya
whatever.
Baat hai, Anushka Sharma, the philosopher.
I'm sadhu. with this thing on my head also, I'm like talking also like one sadhu.
And Anushka, how easily do you get swayed by success or affected by failure?
Success and failure are both imposters.
Oh.
So treat them the same way. I think, you know, success, failure, disappointments, these are all things that... that are just transitory, you know, they are going to pass. And I think you can't lose yourself too much in it. It's not easier. It's much easier said than done. But I work on it. So I actively work on it. I'm not saying that, oh, main to mujhe koi farak hi nahi padta and all. I never allowed this to create some kind of fear in me, you know. Failure okay. should not create a fear in you that you start basing all your judgments and your decisions on fear.
Do you believe in the blaming game? If this was it, then probably we could have done that.
I wish I knew who to blame. Like perhaps maybe I would, I don't know. But I have no idea. Like, I don't know, I can't assess a film as to why the film has not done well or who's responsible for it. So I don't think I can.
Now, these are some questions which you have to answer only in yes or no.
Achha.
Okay, no need to elaborate, no need to explain.
Very difficult this is for me to not elaborate.
Okay, then we shall make exceptions. Okay. Whenever you feel like elaborating, just okay. put your hand up and we'll...
Okay.
Do you believe in the camp system in Bollywood?
No.
Have you ever felt intimidated by any of your co-stars?
Yes.
If you can name...
Salman.
And why?
Because he's intimidating.
Yeah.
His personality is such that you feel a bit like...
Do you have directorial dreams?
No.
Have you ever cried after reading something about yourself in the newspapers or magazines?
Yes.
If you can. It's so interesting. So I would like you to elaborate.
I've forgotten also.
Achha, but you
I forget bad things.
But you did cry.
I know I've cried, yeah.
Rab ne bana di jodi?
What? The yes question? Or no? Yes, it's a film I did.
Ah, very smart. You're so smart. One word answers now, huh? One word to describe award ceremonies in India.
Pleasant.
The one actress you think is your biggest competition.
I can't name one.
Suppose we were to allow you to name three.
Kangana and Alia, mostly, and Deepika also.
Very nice. Who would you want beside you all the time, jab tak hai jaan, till your dying day?
My shadow.
Ah! So you call it's him or her shadow?
My shadow is never going to leave me. So I'm only trusting my shadow.
The one aspect of your life that makes your dil dhadakne do?
My pet. Dude.
Okay. Who is your badmash company?
My brother.
Karnesh. And these are what ifs. What if Karan Johar had succeeded in dissuading Yash Raj Films to sign you up?
I think the industry would be losing.
Ah! Lovely, lovely. Losing out on a great actress.
Would be losing out on a committed actress.
What if you go to a party and another actress is wearing the same dress as yours?
Well, that does not happen because the stylists are very careful.
What if you were a matchmaker? Who would you find a match for in Bollywood?
I want to find a match for my manager. Please, that's all my interest. That's my only interest. I'm more interested in Bollywood and all. They'll find their matches. They have no problem. I'm finding for my manager.
How
that's
sweet
my mission.
Is that? How sweet is that? What if you could trade lives with anyone for 24 hours? Whom would you want to be?
Oh, yeah. Right now, I think I want to be Donald Trump. Just, I want to know what's going on in that head.
Oh, wow. Very nice. Anushka, it has been great. Great talking to you.
Like.
Lively as always. Fun as always. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you so much.
And we've got a certificate for you before you leave.
Oh, really? That I have been good?
Here you are.
Thank you. Oh, how sweet.
Thank you. And we've got a small token of our appreciation for you coming all the way to
hamper.
Our studio. Yes, hamper.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
I love all hampers and I love that there's tea in this. Yes. I'm most happy about that. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Here, if I talk business, my salary is cut.
You lose on business. I became full ready to talk about numbers only. As soon as I see, sir, I just start seeing numbers.